This morning in the city's latest homicide, detectives believe man's best friend may have played a role. A rare Sunday session is scheduled for the Senate today. A big vote could mean a big changes for several departments. If you're looking for a way to get in the holiday spirit, we have just the thing for you. We're live at the Festival of Trees. And it's a foggy start to this Sunday morning. Will we see a warm-up this week? Meteorologist George Flickinger is tracking some changes. Plus, weekend weather trivia.
Well, it's a big TV.
You're watching Two News Works for You in High Definition.
Good Sunday morning, and thanks for joining us. I'm Dina Silk.
I'm meteorologist George Flickinger, and yes, we are both wearing purple today.
We got the color memo. I like it.
You like it? We didn't actually plan this. Just kind of happened this way.
Worked out.
Cloudy skies, fog, and drizzle this morning. We are going to have a beautiful afternoon ahead, but a cool start. 44 degrees with a south wind and also some mist in green country. Coming up, election news. Right. What to expect for the weekend.
It might get kind of loud when I turn it up for that.
Police believe a dispute over dogs led to a man's murder. Five people have been arrested in connection to the death of 40-year-old Guy Gilmore Jones. He was found dead in his home near I-244 and North Utica Friday afternoon. Jones' girlfriend told police a dog was missing from the residence and that she and Jones recently had been involved in a disturbance with two people over English bulldogs. Police determined that Jones had taken a dog from one of the suspects and that several of the suspects later assaulted Jones. The five suspects are now in jail on complaints of first-degree murder. A huge drug ring is busted and 44 people are now in jail. FBI agents say a Norman family used their business to distribute the painkiller oxycodone.
What?
A year-long investigation, authorities say the family got other people involved by scheduling doctor's appointments.